get inspired, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in to another quarantine episode of Life Inspired. We are so grateful that you would tune in and watch. We ask that you would like our Facebook page, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Another way that you can watch and share this video is from lifeinspiredshow.com. That's the website address that we've got just for the show. It'll direct you that you can see several episodes. And we really appreciate you sharing these programs with people that need to hear how God could turn somebody's life around. Everybody's story is different and everybody connects with God in a different way. And so we are just praying that just one person's going to hear today's story that it's going to be really impactful for. And I have a very special guest today. I'm so excited to introduce to you virtually from home in the safety of her quarantined house with her three little ones at home. We have Brittney Baily from B100.
Hello, it's so good to be here. Thank you. With you in spirit.
We're so excited to have you. So before we start these episodes, you guys, we normally like hold hands and pray. So like TJ's praying for us, like, and we're all like not holding hands. I don't know if you guys can see TJ's way in the back booth in the other room over there. And so we're doing our social distancing from here. And Brittany's not socially distant from the kiddos. Are they doing a little bit of homeschool, Brittany?
Yeah, we do homeschool actually. So it's kind of normal for us to be doing school at home.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, is that I'm not working right now, so they think that I'm on vacation. So it's a win-win.
Right. I'm like, Mom's here. We can play. Very good. Very cool. So we typically, Brittney, will talk about life was going along and there's a ... turning point moment in your life that God changed your feet to a new direction. So sometimes it's your, you know, I didn't know God and now I know God and I'm walking with God. And sometimes it's I've been walking with God for a long time, but now he's got me doing something new. So I don't know what turning point story you're going to tell, but if you could, you know, share with us a backstory. Let's do first the question, what was going on before the dots?
Sure. Okay. I'm so excited to share this because truly it all revolves around my little guy. My son, he has passed away, but he changed our lives in the most amazing ways possible. So my husband and I got married in 2012 and he was a non-believer, but he would listen to me. And I have always known Jesus. I don't know a time that I wasn't a Christian. And so for me, I would pray for him all the time. And sadly, it took Elijah to pass away, but I truly believe that God used him to save his dad's life. And so it was 2015 when we had our turning point moment.
So Elijah was your first child in 2015? He's the first child you guys had?
We had one son prior in 2012. His name is Liam, and he's 7 years old now. So we had a two-year-old at the time.
Oh, okay. So Liam was two, and then Elijah was born. What can you tell us about the story of Elijah's birth? So was he early when he was born?
So Elijah's story was really incredible. I went in for my anatomy scan at 18 weeks, and immediately we just knew that something was wrong. And because I've had more babies since, I know now when something is really wrong, just by the atmosphere in the room, and the way that the ultrasound tech might be looking at the screen. And so Elijah had measured extremely small and he wasn't growing. And so the doctor looked at me and he said, this is really serious. He said, I need you to go get blood work and I need you to go see a specialist. And so I remember that afternoon, I went to the South Bend Medical Foundation and I was a mess because I was just told that my baby was really, really sick. And the lady taking my blood didn't even know who I was. And she grabs my hand and she says, no, in the name of Jesus, we are going to claim that your baby will be okay because he is so good. He is so good. And she kept talking about God's goodness. And in that moment, it was hard to feel God's goodness because I was just told that my baby was pretty sick. And so I thought, but she was so right. She spoke such truth. When Satan wanted to fight me with these feelings of doubt and fear, this angel, truly, she just spoke truth into my heart and my soul. And I thought, I'm going to be victorious through this because I know who's on my side. So then we felt empowered. And then we went to see the specialist. And again, Satan was fighting us so hard because that was a terrible appointment. The ultrasound showed that his umbilical cord had not formed properly. He only had one kidney. He had something called hydrop, so there was fluid all over his body. And no one knew what was wrong. They said there are three parts to every pregnancy, mom, baby, and placenta. And right now, we don't know what's wrong. We know you're okay, but he is very, very sick. So the doctor looked at me and said, your son is going to die. Brittney, you have to be prepared for this. And so I grabbed his hand, the specialist that I've never met before, and I said, will you pray with me? So that's all I know how to do in times of despair, in times of happiness, just run to my Abba. So I said, God, you give and you take away. I'm going to hold on to this little boy. I'm going to fight for him. And so we were prepared, though, because I knew what the ultrasound had showed, and I knew that he was very sick. And all the while, my husband was not a believer, but he would pray with me. He was very open-minded to everything. And it was on that Good Friday of 2015 that we went to an amazing church service. Oh, wow. And he came out of that church service and he said, I've been wrong for a really long time. And it was like God was igniting his soul because he knew what was lying ahead for us that year. And so to have my husband saved was amazing. But to know that he was there as my prayer partner and to hold me up when I was so weak was incredible. And I saw such a transformation in his hope. And he had served in the Army, so he has kind of had that Army mentality. And so having that fighter mentality, he said, this is a battle, but we're going to win because we have God on our side. And so it helped me in the hardest of things. When I was so weak, he would hold me up, and he constantly would have this hope that was so unwavering, that it was contagious for someone who was a lifelong believer to have feelings of doubt and have this new believer in the thick of something so strong. It was just amazing that he was encouraging me the way that he was. But Elijah kept living and living and living, and every day was such a gift. I would rock him in a rocking chair.
So guys watching, whether you're watching YouTube or Facebook or whatever, we're having technological difficulties, which is normal when, you know, we've got a remote. Is this a computer or a laptop, Brittney?
Laptop. Yeah.
It's a laptop. Okay, so we're just dealing with, you know, the Wi-Fi at Brittany's location right now, which, you know, I know at my own house it's really rough. But what I've heard you say is, like, the whole story recap, Elijah at 18 weeks gestation is when you found out that he was sick. Did we already know he was a boy and name him Elijah, or it was later you did that?
A couple weeks later, we did genetic testing.
Okay.
To see if there was anything that might show up. And then the good news was that he was a boy.
Okay. So your older son, Liam, was 2. He's 18 weeks gestation. You find out he's sick. You go to get your blood work done. That's where the woman prays with you. You go and see the specialist, and he tells you more bad news, and you ask him to pray with you. Then on Good Friday of 2015, you go to the Good Friday service at your church, and your husband meets Christ for the first time. And then since then, your husband becomes the rock. Even though you've known Christ for a long time, your husband is like, no, I'm an Army guy. This is a battle. God's bigger. Yep. And when you first said that, when you first started saying that part, Brittney, I know of a picture that is of David and Goliath. And there's this picture of little bitty David and big old Goliath over here. I don't know if you can, you know, kind of imagine this in your mind, because it's just my hands, right? But then there's this angel of God that is so much bigger than Goliath. And no wonder little bitty Goliath isn't scared, because he knows who's on his side, right? So I just picture that. Your husband just knew God's on our side. So go back to that. So God's on your side. He's brave and bold. And you then started, before it broke up, you started to tell us a little bit about that you would rock your son. So was Elijah born at some point? Was he born, or you were rocking him inside your tummy?
I would rock him in my belly, and I would sing to him because I knew that he could hear me no matter how ill he was. I knew that he still knew his mama loved him. And so I had to go see the specialist again, which they weren't expecting, because they kept saying he's going to die any day, any day. Well, he kept living. And so when I went to that same specialist, who said, any day now, he looked at the ultrasound screen and he said, Brittney, I cannot explain this. God has his gaze on your baby. And that was so amazing, because a boy who went from having fluid all over his body to an umbilical cord that wasn't formed properly and one kidney, all of a sudden the fluid was gone, the umbilical cord was healed, and he had a second kidney, which they might not have seen that on the first scan, but I truly believe that a kidney was planted. And so it was amazing. We left that appointment on such a high. And so a couple of weeks later, I was not feeling him move. And I thought, well, this might be it. Mm-hmm. So it was about 3 a.m. and I had my Bible open and I just said, God, he is not mine. He is yours. But Lord, I'm just believing. I'm believing in healing. I know who you are and know what you can do. So I just opened the Bible, just put it on my belly, and he starts kicking and kicking and kicking. And it was amazing. And I opened the Bible.
Oh, how beautiful.
Psalm 103 has really been our battle cry because that's where it was placed and that's where he was kicking. And it says he heals all of our diseases. And I thought, I'm not giving up. And I'm not exaggerating when I tell you this. Like, I could feel just this presence, and I heard, your faith has healed you. And I thought, oh, faith has healed Elijah. Well, I now know that my faith has healed me. And it's not me that's done anything. It's the power of God that's done the healing. Because right. Then fast forward to 2015, on January 10th, he was 41 weeks. So a baby lived 23 weeks longer than any doctor ever could have predicted. And they had heart monitors on him. And I prayed with every person that came into that room. And I can tell you, it felt like holy ground. There was just such a spirit of God in this delivery room. And so we had the heart monitor on him. And his heart was beating strong until he was born. And he had passed. The birth was just too hard for him. He did have one heart chamber that was not formed properly. And it was the hardest thing. I mean, I was actually fighting for him in labor while every pain, every contraction, I was just saying, the name of Jesus, it's your will. It's your Amen. Will. And I said, you know, Satan, you might be trying to fight me, but I know whose baby this is. And so my husband and I, we were singing, and we were just trying to do our best to cope. And he was so beautiful. He looked just like my husband. He had curly hair, and he was beautiful. And so I know that the last thing he heard was Mom fighting for him, and the first thing he saw was the face of Jesus. And I can't imagine what that was like for him. But a couple days later, we were planning his funeral, and it was just incredibly hard. But my husband came in to me and he said, I want to be baptized. And I thought, a baptism at a funeral? I've never seen this happen, but let's do it. My uncle, who is really influential in our lives, he was able to baptize my husband. And before he did, Patrick got up there and he said, you know, my son came to save my life. And when he died, it wasn't one soul that went to heaven, but two. And Elijah's mission was accomplished. And so when Patrick came up out of the water, all dressed in black with Elijah's tiny white casket, I've never seen anything more powerful in my life. And my aunt spoke and she said, if this tiny baby has touched your life like he's touched mine, why don't you stand up? And we turned around and 350 people were standing up. I just knew that we weren't alone. In the hardest of days, when I had to be carried up the stairs because the pain was so bad.
No, let him in. Put him in the picture. I want to meet him. Tell us who's who.
So, this is Hope.
Scrunch him in close. Okay. TJ, you're going to have to pull out. TJ, pull out so we can see all of them. So Liam is on your right, my left. Hi, Liam. And then Hope. Hi, sweetheart. And then your other son is?
Nigel. Say hi, Nigel.
Nigel. He's like below the camera. I can't see him anymore. That's awesome. So Brittany has 5 babies. She has Elijah in heaven and these 3 here homeschooling. And then little one is due. Yeah, little one in mommy's tummy. That's awesome. Very cool. I think they need you, Mama. We might need to wrap this up just so you can go be with your little ones. So I'm just going to tell you guys, if you want to hook up with Brittany, we will hook you up with Brittany. If you want to have virtual coffee with her or something like that, message us and we'll put you in touch. If you know somebody that needs to hear this story, every life is so valuable. This little Elijah touched so many lives, saved his dad's life, and touched so many lives. Wow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Anything else you want to tell? Anything else you want to share, Brittney?
Well, this is Hope, and we named her Hope because 3 months to the day of Elijah's death, we decided we weren't going to have any more babies for a while, and God is just so redeeming because I got pregnant 3 months to the day with her, and she was actually due on Elijah's birthday, but she had other plans. She came a little early, so I had 2 babies in 1 year, but it was just amazing to have a baby bring back such hope. Because that's the God we serve. He knew what my heart needed in healing ways. And so every little thing, every little detail, I just see him. And it truly, he is so good. And I just know that really our prayer and our battle cry is your will. And his will is to strengthen us and give us hope and give us good things. So he is good. And I thank you for this.
Amen. I am so grateful to have met you, Brittney, and to have heard your story. Thank you so much for sharing. Very much. All right, you guys that are watching on Facebook or YouTube, thank you, thank you, thank you. God bless you and have a great week. Bye, Hope.